As a developer, staying up to date with the latest trends, tools, and techniques is crucial to remaining competitive. And yet, it feels like every week brings new front-end frameworks, AWS services, and AI tools. The development industry moves very fast. How can we stay afloat? I'm not complaining, though. It means that there's always new ideas and concepts to discover, and I love learning. But it can be challenging to keep up with the latest changes. It's a question I ask when I'm interviewing somebody for a job. How do you keep up to date? I'll share the process that I use so that you can pick up anything that you find helpful. Over time, I've built up a kind of learning funnel, a process for ingesting and digesting new ideas. This funnel has three phases: the exploring phase, where I find new ideas and concepts, the tasting phase, where I decide which ideas I want to dive into, and the mastery phase, where I delve into specific ideas. Allow me to explain. The exploring phase involves discovering new ideas and concepts as new technologies and software solutions emerge. Here, the goal is to cast as wide a net as possible. And this phase is where I use Twitter, newsletters, and a website called Daily Dev. Twitter is useful for listening to the pulse of the tech world. I follow the tools and the frameworks and the people who develop them. People like Dan Abramoff, who worked on React, or Rich Harris, who created Svelte, or Ryan Carniato, who created Solid.js, and Misko Every, who created Quick. I also follow various influencers like Ben Awad, whose tutorials I've watched, and Theo from Ping, and more. I also use Reddit, and I follow relevant subreddits to web development and front-end development and more. Another invaluable source of news is newsletters. This is the perfect opportunity to give a shout out to the This Week in React newsletter by Sebastian Lorber. The newsletter provides a weekly roundup of everything that has gone on in the world of React, all the debates, all the news, all the drama. Well, there isn't really that much drama, but it's an invaluable resource for staying on top of what is happening in React. Of course, this may not be fully objective, since the newsletter occasionally features some of my content. Another source of news is the Daily Dev website. They provide a browser extension, and every time I open a new tab, I'm shown my personal Daily Dev feed. This makes staying up to date with the latest news easy without going out of my way to find it. And of course, you can personalize the content to your interests, filter out the noise, and only see relevant articles. It's an excellent resource for staying up to date with the news, mainly because it keeps putting that news in front of my nose. It surfaces relevant blog posts from websites like CSS Tricks and Smashing Magazine, FreeCodeCamp, and Dev2 and Medium, where developers share their insights and their ideas. Once I've cast my net wide, I try to identify what is worth exploring further. The second phase of the learning funnel, the tasting phase, is about sifting through the ideas, the concepts, and the tools that I've discovered in the first phase, and then deciding which I want to explore more. In this phase, I do three things. I read the documentation, I watch YouTube videos that cover points that are related to the subject, and I start running Hello World type projects where I play around with the tools to get a taste of how things work and to get a feel for the developer experience. Finally, we have the third phase, where I dive deep into specific subjects. Here, I use a trick called the Feynman technique. At its core, the principle is simple. If you understand something, you should be able to explain it clearly. It's a technique that you can use to solve a problem. Try to explain it, if need be, to an inanimate object like a plastic duck. In the context of the learning funnel and given a specific idea, here's how it goes. First, I try to explain it like you're five. I pretend that I'm teaching the concept to somebody completely new to the subject, a young child or a non-technical person. I try to break down the concepts and explain it in the simplest of terms. Second, I identify gaps in what I'm explaining as it raises the questions in my mind, and then I try to find the answers. Then I try to simplify and find analogies to illustrate and explain the concepts. This reinforces my understanding and helps make the concept easier to grasp. After that, I record the explanation. Now, having a YouTube channel is useful here, but you can also write a blog post or just jot notes down in a journal. Finally, I try to find a real audience, a friend or a colleague, to teach them the concept. Their questions and their feedback help refine the understanding. There you have it, the learning funnel that I use. Let me know if it was helpful to you, and if it was, I think you'll find the next video helpful too. I'll see you there.